On behalf of Greater Memphis Chamber, we will highlight people and companies who offer a forward lean approach to the growth of our great city. We will share a closer look at what makes Memphis attractive for economic growth, innovation, and expansion, as well as talent retention, tourism, education, good health, and great business. Welcome to Memphians on the Move by Methodist Lavonner Healthcare. I'm your host, Stephanie White. But first, with an institutional vision of becoming a national model for technical career and transfer education, Southwest Tennessee Community College's mission, in part, is to provide the Mid-South region with high-quality and affordable post-secondary education that prepares them for professional degrees, future educational opportunities, and successful employment. I'd like to welcome to the show Anita Bracken, Associate VP of Workforce and Economic Development of Southwest Tennessee Community College. Anita, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Stephanie. We're happy to be here. And also on behalf of our president, Dr. Tracy Hall, we appreciate the opportunity to be here to showcase Southwest.
Excellent. I know that Dr. Hall would have wanted to be here today, but can you give us a leadership overview on her behalf?
So Southwest is a multicultural public open access college, and we are a two-year community college, part of the Tennessee Board of Regents system. And we focus on those three words, multicultural, open access, and public, because we are the community's college. And with many programs that are available to bring students to us, we feel like that we are able to do what we say we're going to do, which is serve our community by preparing our students to be lifelong citizens who are contributing to the economy of Memphis.
Okay, so you've touched on the accessibility of Southwest and its reach, and I wanted to also note that there have been some significant accomplishments at the college to note, such as joining Achieving the Dream Network. What can you share with us about that strategic plan?
So Achieving the Dream is a national network of colleges who partner together to focus on what can the colleges do to improve the student experience so that we are being able to bring the students to us, provide the services that they need to be successful, and then to focus on at the graduation rates of these students. Many of the services that we have put into place at Southwest include wraparound services such as a counselor on staff. We have a veteran support center. We have resources that help the students cover expenses that are outside of the realm of tuition assistance that they may be receiving from other sources.
All right, so with that being noted and the fact that you all are doing so much to support the students, do you all provide childcare?
Yes, we do have a daycare on campus, and the students are able to apply and have their children go to that daycare. It is at our Macon campus and at our Union Avenue campus.
Okay. All right, well, I know that you're going to give us some information about the statistics of things that are going on over there at Southwest. And I want you to stay with us as we talk more with Anita about Southwest Tennessee Community College's workforce development pipeline after these messages.
Secure your future in the hottest careers with a certificate or degree from Southwest. A business degree can open doors to a wide range of opportunities. Engineering and information technicians are in demand to help power manufacturing and logistics. From the kitchen to the cafe, culinary careers are sizzling. And paralegal studies majors are in demand. A wide range of programs for the most in-demand careers are just another reason Southwest Tennessee Community College is your best choice.
Would you rather go to the beach or to the mountains?
I would rather go to the mountains.
I'd rather go to the beach. Favorite movie genre?
Comedy, for sure. What's your favorite?
I love a good action film.
Night Owl.
Early Bird.
Basketball.
Football.
Pancakes.
Waffles.
Have you ever had a medical procedure?
Yes, I had a kidney transplant at Methodist.
Wow, I was not expecting that. Today is my 9-month anniversary of my kidney transplant.
No place I'd rather be when it came to get my transplant but at Methodist.
Begin a new and exciting career as a truck driver with training at Olympic Career Training Institute. Get your Class A CDL truck driving license in just 4 weeks and starting salary making up to $50,000 a year. Must be 21 years of age and have a valid driver's license. The class is also background friendly and job placement assistance is available. Class is filling up fast. Secure your enrollment. Don't wait. Call today. 901-350-6284. Olympic Career Training Institute.
Tay Computer Systems is your authorized Apple service provider, recognized as the Mid-South's go-to tech company for fast, quality computer service. Here at Tay Computer Systems is where you'll find the highest qualified technicians and great customer service with the fastest turnaround time. So come see us for broken screens, data transfers, virus removals, upgrades, and more. We provide and repair all brands of PCs and Apple products. So make sure you don't wait. Take it to Tay.
We are back with Anita Bracken, Associate Vice President of Workforce and Economic Development at Southwest Tennessee Community College. Southwest is a major workforce development pipeline in Memphis and a major player in the state of Tennessee's drive to 55. Efforts to reach 55% of Tennesseans with a credential by 2025. So Anita, where does the college stand to date on this initiative?
So our students can come to us for our 100 plus programs. We have Associate of Arts degrees, Associate of Science, Associate of Applied Science, teacher certificates, and over 25 technical certificates that the students can use to put them to work. We have an overall job placement rate of 98%, with many of our programs putting students to work 100% of that rate, and students majoring in their field, at least 88% are going into their chosen field that they've studied. So the tuition-free programs that the state has available are continuing to bring students to us to take advantage of those many programs.
In recent years, there's been an increase in the credentials conferred. So can we unpack some of those numbers?
So beginning in 2017, once we began our work with our Achieving the Dream Network, we started seeing an immediate increase. We had a 24% increase in the number of credentials conferred for 2017. Our fall enrollment increased 10% that year. And we have continued to see an enrollment semester over semester at Southwest. So currently we are on a roll to have 10,000 students strong for fall of 2019. And we're seeing a lot of great increases, again, based on Tennessee Promise and Tennessee Reconnect. We really feel like those programs have reached to the masses of what it can do to bring the students to us.
So with a large influx of numbers, you have to have several campuses. So how many campuses are there of Southwest?
So Southwest actually has 7 campuses. We're spread throughout Memphis, Whitehaven, Millington, so we're in Shelby County. We actually have a new location in Fayette County, which is in Somerville. So we are really looking forward to having our Fayette County students begin their journey with Southwest.
Very good. That's excellent. Well, we'll return with more from Anita Bracken after a message from Epicenter, the hub of entrepreneurship. Today is my grand opening. Just the start of a new beginning for Big Mamas and Grannies. Big Mamas and Grannies was actually my big mama and my granny. Everything that they instilled in me, I want to give to others. We specialize in Southern soul to American tradition with occasional Creole twist.
You have to eat the food.
That chicken salad is remarkable.
The macaroni and cheese is literally the best thing you've ever put into your mouth.
My favorite food is macaroni and cheese.
Kanaka represents where passion and perseverance meets resources. Memphis has tons of talented people with gifts. They just don't have the resources to fund those gifts. So I think Tanaka's story represents what Memphis can be.
Pathway Lending is one of those organizations that provide the necessary financing to women-owned businesses and black-owned businesses, even veterans as well. We're in a place that we can provide financing necessary to grow a community from within.
Pathway is a really important partner because they're nationally recognized experts in distribution of capital to emerging businesses. Together, we solve a very significant challenge for entrepreneurs in Memphis.
Everything that you see in here today, the funding from Pathway Lending allowed me to do that. This has really allowed my vision and my dreams to really come true. A lot of times, because you're a woman, you're seen unable to do. So I've always had that determination of nothing can stop me.
I'm going to keep pushing. I wish that everybody in the city of Memphis knew about Epicenter and Pathway Lending. If I'd never gotten a phone call from Epicenter, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't.
We left off talking about the programs that are offered by Southwest. So, Anita, can you tell us what are some examples of your programs and approximately how many are new to the college?
Well, thank you, Stephanie. We actually do have several new programs. I think one I'd really like to highlight is our Funeral Services Education Program. That is a unique program that was really developed based on input from the community. There is no other local funeral service education for our area residents to seek out. The only other one is a private college in Nashville. So as a Tennessee Board of Regents two-year college, we were able to put one in to get it approved. The classes started this past semester, and we actually had an overwhelming response to the program. We thought we would start with one cohort of students, and we actually ended up with both a day and an evening section. So those classes are held at our Whitehaven campus, and the full setup for the students to be able to experience everything that they need to experience in that program is being set up there at the Whitehaven campus. So again, the community really helped us get that program going.
That's excellent that you all listen to the community and the demands that they have in order to be able to bring more programs. So just curious, I know that a lot of people may not realize it's not just a program where you can just be coming from high school, and you mentioned that earlier, you have a lot of adults that are returning to school. So for those who may be a little nervous, what would you suggest if they're looking to return to school with so many programs that you all have to offer?
Well, definitely they can step foot on any Southwest campus and we're going to be very welcoming to them. We do see some students who like to come to Southwest through kind of a different pathway, and that would be potentially a non-credit program, maybe a short-term class to get their feet wet. What we do is they're all Southwest students to us, whether they're non-credit or credit. So we serve over 3,000 students in our non-credit programs. Many of those, you know, they may just be taking one class for professional development. We see a lot of people taking computer type classes, or we have longer term certification preparation programs. High demand in the healthcare field, in the IT field, the business field. So that's one way to get somebody to Southwest. And then once we get them in, we help transition them into future programs if that's their desire, or they may exit out and come back to us at a later point.
And that's excellent, because a lot of our adults are looking at the fact that they're returning to school, so the ease of which there may be for getting back in. But then also, as far as the finances of returning, you did mention earlier something about money that is available. So what is something that you could possibly share with our returning to school learners?
So we definitely want to highlight the Tennessee Reconnect, and that is for the adults who are returning to complete a post-secondary credential. Many programs that we have added just in the last couple of years in anticipation of those students. One of the areas that we really focus on is our medical device community, Memphis being the second largest medical device region in the U.S., and we have put in new programs that the individuals can do. We have a one semester medical device finishing course. That's a pathway into a great job at one of our local companies. And then for the students, if they continue on, we have several additional new certificates and degree programs that reach out to that field.
So of course you cater to those who are returning to college, but then of course you have those high school students who are looking to figure out where they would like to go, and they may not necessarily want to leave home. So how do you all welcome those high school students to Southwest to make them see that this is the place that they should be?
We do a lot of wraparound support to our students and a lot of early engagement. When they set foot on campus, that's the critical point, is to get the students engaged. We expanded our advising staff considerably so that we have more people available to work with our students. And we have an amazing faculty. So once the students get there and get in class, they're going to become a part of the Southwest family.
And that's good to know, because a lot of times we want to make sure that they don't feel as though they are leaving from a smaller environment to a larger environment and then getting lost. All right, well, stay tuned for more Memphians on the Move with Anita Bracken after this short break.
Do you like wings? Then you will love All Star, where we offer the whole wing and many more mouth-watering items. So come in and visit us at Highway 64, just east of Applin Road, or Perkins and Knight Arnold. All Star, home of the whole wing.
Hello, welcome to Christ Community.
I immediately felt something different. You know, it's loving care because loving is living up to their name. It's complete care with medical, dental, behavioral health, and pharmacy right in my community. Loving care for your body, mind, and spirit. Call 901-842-3160 or log on to ChristCommunityHealth.org for an appointment. Christ Community Health Services, healing with soul.
Tay Computer Systems is your authorized Apple service provider, recognized as the Mid-South's go-to tech company for fast, quality computer service. Here at Tay Computer Systems is where you'll find the highest qualified technicians and great customer service with the fastest turnaround time. So come see us for broken screens, data transfers, virus removals, upgrades, and more. We provide and repair all brands of PCs and Apple products. So make sure you don't wait. Take it to Tate.
Begin a new and exciting career as a truck driver with training at Olympic Career Training Institute. Get your Class A CDL truck driving license in just 4 weeks and starting salary making up to $50,000 a year. Must be 21 years of age and have a valid driver's license. The class is also background friendly and job placement assistance is available. Class is filling up fast. Secure your enrollment. Don't wait. Call today. 901-350-6284. Olympic Career Training Institute.
All-Star Hot Wings, your place to go for whole wings. Or try our jumbo cheeseburger, turkey burger, Philly cheesesteak. We've got lots for you to eat. Are you hungry? All-Star Hot Wings, Perkins Road or Highway 64.
Now, Southwest Tennessee Community College, the operative word there is community, because not only are you all helping the students, but you're also partnering with the community in quite a few ways. Can you tell us something about that?
Yes, we have been very blessed to have been the recipient of several grants that have come to us. One is from the Women's Foundation, part of their initiative this year, and the other from EDGE, and that one's called the Ready Whitehaven Grant. Both of those are to provide women entry-level careers into the healthcare field. Through both of those programs, Women's Foundation, we're working in the 38126 zip code, and the Ready Whitehaven Grant through EDGE, we're focusing on the Whitehaven community and offering programs in dialysis technician, EKG technician, medical administrative assistant. We've had dental assisting out there. All of those programs can be offered in a condensed curriculum, kind of a very intensive 3-month program, but we're preparing those women to take the national certification test so they can go into those fields. And we know that once we get them into those great positions, then we do see many of them that really embrace the careers available in the healthcare field. And of course, we're always wanting to see them advance, you know, as they have the opportunity. Well, we're so fortunate that those two organizations have provided support to Southwest to do those programs over the last several years, and we're looking forward to seeing our next classes get started in July to help the women in those communities.
Okay, so you also have some information to share with us regarding the workforce investment. What can you share with us about
so
that?
We also are partnering with other organizations for classes. One is the Greater Memphis Chamber. We've had a program that we put together, 8 weeks to export. So it's a program designed to give individuals who are getting into the logistics field kind of an overview of what that field encompasses. There's a lot of terminology and just understanding what's the difference between import, what's export. And with the Chamber's help and the support of the World Trade Club, we just recently kicked off that class, I believe 2 weeks ago. And that's one of the areas that we're focusing on is our logistics sector. Another area that we're focusing on is our manufacturing, and we have invested heavily in the top of the line training equipment so that our companies can either send their employees to us for technical training, or we can actually take a lot of that training on site. We have portable training systems. 2 weeks ago, we had seven of our major manufacturers come to us, look at the program, and then now we're reaching back out because we know now we really need to go to, you know, out to into the community. We can't always expect everyone to come to our campus at, you know, on Monday, Wednesday night and take a class. We've got to be much more flexible in our delivery.
And in your being more flexible with the delivery, of course, we know that students would have to be technologically savvy. So what support do you all provide to people who may be a little leery when they're first returning to school, or you may have some high school students who are graduating who may not be as up on their computer skills, although I'm sure with as much technology as they use, they might. But what support do you all offer with technology?
So we do offer the career readiness certificate, and that's for individuals who come to us and may want to take a test to see, you know, what are their skill levels in the reading and the writing and the math portions. And by doing that, then we can see, are there any gaps that need to be filled? And then we can put together a prescriptive plan for the students. We want them to be as successful as possible when they get into the classes. And we don't want anyone to walk in and all of a sudden feel overwhelmed.
So Anita, what are some of your personal takeaways from the Southwest culture?
Well, again, we are the community's college, and what I've really been so excited to be a part of for the past several years with Southwest is to see the impact that we have in the community. We know that when an individual comes into us, that gives us an opportunity to touch that student's life, and then our joy is to watch that student as they leave with their certificate or graduate with a full 2-year degree and be successful in our community.
Okay. We will have final thoughts with Anita Bracken, Associate Vice President of Economic and Workforce Development at Southwest Tennessee Community College, after a word from the desk of Greater Memphis Chamber President Beverly Robertson.
I have had the opportunity as the new president of the Greater Memphis Chamber to spend some time out in the field talking to business leaders, and their number one concern is workforce development because it is difficult for them to find employees to work in their various businesses, whether that be the construction trades or medical device industry, automotive industry, or even in major corporations. So, in response to the resounding voices of both job seekers and employers and the expressed need to bridge the gap between talent and opportunities, the Greater Memphis Chamber will convene regional stakeholders for the workforce ecosystem on October 22nd and 23rd with a summit called Upskill 901. The goal of that summit is to upskill 10,000 individuals with technical and essential skills for today's job and future jobs and expose them to high demand careers and direct employment opportunities over the next 12 to 36 months. We're hosting this 2-day summit, which will include breakfast and lunch, keynote addresses from national experts, breakout sessions, and CEO roundtables on day one, and a preparation meets opportunity career fair on day two. Here, attendees will be provided multiple resources from on-site registrations for programs to employer screenings for open positions. I mean, positions that are open today. So for more information on the Upskill 901 Workforce Summit, listen for this in the news and visit memphischamber.com.
Would you rather go to the beach or to the mountains?
I would rather go to the mountains.
I'd rather go to the beach. Favorite movie genre?
Comedy, for sure. What's your favorite?
I love a good action film.
Night Owl.
Early Bird.
Basketball.
Football.
Pancakes.
Waffles.
Have you ever had a medical procedure?
Yes, I had a kidney transplant at Methodist.
Wow, I was not expecting that. Today is my 9-month anniversary of my kidney transplant.
No place I'd rather be when it came to get my transplant but at Methodist.
Secure your future in the hottest careers with a certificate or degree from Southwest. A business degree can open doors to a wide range of opportunities. Engineering and information technicians are in demand to help power manufacturing and logistics. From the kitchen to the cafe, culinary careers are sizzling. And paralegal studies majors are in demand. A wide range of programs for the most in-demand careers are just another reason Southwest Tennessee Community College is your best choice.
The Memphis branch was the second of three regional branches established by the Federal Reserve Bank of St. Louis, one of 12 independent reserve banks that, along with the Board of Governors in Washington, D.C., make up the Federal Reserve System, the central banking system of the United States. The Federal Reserve promotes a healthy economy and financial stability. To do that, it performs five important roles. One, keep inflation low and stable. Two, foster a healthy banking system. Three, provide payment services to financial institutions. Four, support the U.S. Treasury's financial operations. And five, promote financial literacy and economic education. The regional branch offices help the St. Louis Fed fulfill its mission and serve as the voice of Main Street when monetary policy decisions are made. They also allow for a more efficient collection of information and deeper relationships through staff involvement in the local economies, producing a level of insight not possible from hundreds of miles away.
Anita, you've shared a tremendous amount of valuable information about Southwest and the programs that are offered. Can you tell us about other exciting news that may be underway at Southwest?
Well, absolutely. This week we're excited because we are back in our summer session. And as always, we love having the students around. It gets a little quiet out there when they're not in class. So we're looking forward to a lot of our new students coming on campus for the first time. This fall, we are kicking off a new degree in communication, and that one is going to be for students who will be interested in the public relations field, the advertising field, pretty much any type of media field. So as we're sitting here today in this studio, we are hoping to get students who come on to Southwest and explore a field such as getting into this.
Well, Anita, in addition to having a lot of academic support in order to make sure that the students are on a great path in order to be able to be successful, productive members of society, I do realize that you all also have a lot of extracurricular activities that are available to the students. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so just being part of a college, we want our students to experience both sides, the academic side and the student life experience. So we do have a number of organizations ranging from Honor Society, clubs that are within certain majors. But we also have something really exciting, which is our international studies programs. And each year students can apply to be an international student. Our students just returned for this year from five different countries. So we had students spread out around the world. Italy, Peru were a couple of the countries that were visited. So I think that's something unique that a lot of people may not realize, that a two-year college has some of the very same type activities as a major or four-year university. In addition, we have great sports teams also at Southwest.
I'd like to thank my guest, Anita Bracken, for sharing such robust insights. And we will see you next time on Greater Memphis Chamber Presents Memphians on the Move by Methodist Le Bonheur Healthcare. I'm your host, Stephanie White. Thanks for watching.